Good afternoon, viewers. Welcome to the next session of COVID Conversations. Since all of us know that the lockdown in the state has been extended to the end of the month of May, a lot of us have been dealing with a lot of mental stress. There's anxiety because of the lockdown. Today at COVID Conversations, Mumbai Mirror will address all your mental health issues with Dr. P.K. Dalal. To give you a quick round of introduction, Dr. P.K. Dalal is a psychiatrist and is the president of Indian Psychiatric Society, which is the country's largest psychiatric society. Let's tune in with Dr. P.K. Dalal to answer all your queries today. Good afternoon, Dr. Dalal. Welcome to the COVID Conversations.
Good afternoon. How are you?
Good, doctor. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. So, Dr. Dalal, let's tune into the questions that we got from a few readers and that we've set up for today. We all know that you've been running a campaign called Mental Health Matters, and since all of us have gone into the digital world to seek help, how are you helping people out there using the new media?
Yes, so through TikTok media, which is a very new to us, through this Mind Matters campaign, which went off very successfully, I would say, that we had 51 very famous psychiatrists of the country. Everybody had contributed. They have uploaded 1 minute video on different topics related to COVID pandemic mental health issues, right? So in them, and it has become very, very successful, and more than probably 150 million people, 150 million shares were there. So we are happy that it has reached to the masses, and there were different topics, so probably people have got benefited by those topics as well.
That's wonderful. Good to know that. I think that's like one of the best ways to use the applications that we have on social media to reach maximum people. So, doctor, the first question for the lockdown is, a lot of us, especially teenage and people who are most of the time out of the house for their jobs, for their responsibilities, are now at home, locked in with their friends or family, which creates kind of stress between family members and a lot of awkwardness that comes with them because it's not something that's habitual for people. How does one go about this? Because a lot of people have been complaining about minute fights with family members or there's certain awkwardness. How does one get through it?
Actually, this is the time to know yourself and your family members, which you probably could not because of your busy schedule before this lockdown. No, so this is, you will have to take it as an opportunity. So you could know about yourself, about your parents, about brothers, sisters, about your grannies if they are staying with you. So, and you can share your views with them. You can share different activities. And if you are working from home, then you can, of course, work from home. But along with that, you can also share the responsibilities. You can tell your near and dear ones, your children, to how to inculcate a new hobby, how to go about, say, playing together, talking together, reading together, singing together, maybe drawing, sketching, dancing, music, all these things, gardening, even cooking together, eating together, praying together. So all these things which you could not do previously, this is the time for you to inculcate all these good habits. You must take around 6 to 8 hours sleep, and you must take a balanced diet. See to it that you shouldn't overeat, or you shouldn't take more of a fatty or carbohydrate foods like that, and do regular exercises and yoga, pranayama, whatever is possible in that, and as well as do not get overwhelmed by the information regarding COVID. So for this reason, you can flip to other channels as well, so that you can see your own, say, maybe you are a fan of old movies, so you can go there, old songs, or maybe Animal Planet, or maybe science fictions and this and that. So this is the time when you can inculcate your hobbies which you could not. Okay.
Great. So basically engage in as much as activities we could and bond with our family in a better way.
And the feeling of togetherness. You feel that the family togetherness is very important.
True. Very true. The next question, doctor, is that since all of us are working from home, people have been complaining that it's getting more stressful for them to working in a situation at home and getting overwhelmed with the amount of information that comes on a daily basis to them. So how does one cope up with the additional amount of stress that's coming on them while they're working from home? Because a lot of people are not habitual to work from home.
Yes. So again, this is a new situation through which everybody is going through. No. So many people who are working from home, I think you must think positive that you are fortunate enough that you have got a job and you are able to work from home and you are able to draw your salary. Whereas, you know, a lot of people in our country and in the whole world, some of them, they have lost their jobs and the situation becomes much more difficult for them. So you are one of the fortunate ones who are able to carry out a job or work from your home. So that is one positive way which you can think of. And the other thing is that you will have to innovate and manage your time schedule accordingly. Now, because of as meetings are also happening on different platforms and you are getting a lot of, as you have said, lot of mails and lot of phone calls and lot of all these things. So in-person meetings are not possible in this situation. So one has to adjust with the new situation. The whole world is adjusting. But you must be hopeful that as the lockdown has already becoming less and less locking, as I would say, that it has already started opening up. So one should be hopeful that in due course of time, it will gradually open up. But this is the time which you should try to utilize, try to keep your calm and make your working room as comfortable, as cozy as possible. And if you want that nobody should interfere during your working hours, especially if there are small children or by your spouse and other people around in the family, then you try to arrange things accordingly. That before this meeting or before you go to work, you must arrange things of your household that by telling them that from this time to this time, I should not be disturbed. But other way around, whatever is required for the family or whatever decisions are to be taken for the family, you should do beforehand so that everything is in place and you can work with your good peace of mind so that you can give your output for the job.
Agreed. Since we have come to the point of jobs, the economic crisis has hit the globe. Yeah. A lot of people have lost their jobs and some of them are living under the fear of losing the job. Mm-hmm. It's adding a lot of stress. Plus, there's already a stress because of the infection, plus the fear of losing a job. People are seeking mental health. How does one cope up with this heavy amount of stress? It's basically like a sword on their heads. People have a big fear of losing jobs and they don't really know how to manage economic crisis at home. How does one go about it?
That is true. I mean, if you see the world over economic situation, and the work situation. So everybody is going through the same kind of uncertainty, you know, everyone. So those who are having job, at least they should feel themselves fortunate and shouldn't get bogged down or worried about that what will happen if I lose my job. So one should not get perturbed by this thing. And I would rather say that take one day at a time. Do not think much ahead. I mean, daily the government's guidelines are being changed, and they are also thinking of opening up the economy and as well as giving some help to the people who are really oppressed or who have lost their jobs. So they should be hopeful about it. And those people who have, unfortunately, they have lost their jobs, they should also be hopeful that in due course of time, when the lockdown is over, they are likely to be absorbed, because then new and new opportunities will come. And in this period of lockdown, if they have lost their job, this is the time to upscale their skills. You know, if they can upscale their skills by doing some online courses or having some experience of all these things, they can really upgrade themselves, and they can be better candidates for having a job. So that one should be basically think positive. That is very, very important. Otherwise, it will be, negativity should not creep in, because everybody is going through the same stage, same kind of thing. And one should try to share it. By sharing it, it decreases the anxiety, depression, uncertainty, all these things, they decrease by sharing that the whole world is going through the same thing.
Agreed. Positive vibes only.
Yeah. Yes.
So the next question has come from a lot of our female audience, women who work from home now because of the situation, and who also take care of the chores at home. So there's additional responsibility of their work that they're doing from home and the chores. And especially women who have been homemakers already have now got a lot of physical work to do, considering that the entire family is now living home. Some families manage dividing chores, some are not able to do that, causing a lot of stress. Because as we know, as with statistics, women have more mental stress than a man would. How do women deal with such situations?
Yeah, but I can also tell you that women are much more resilient, and they are, I would say, born multitaskers. You know, they do multitasking. They take care of their children, their household chores, as well as nowadays most of the women, they are working also. So they will be working, going to their offices or doing jobs or whatever job they are doing. But currently, as you said, that they are at home. So it is the responsibility of the other family members. I would especially say and request the spouses and the children to share the household chores and give some sort of respite to your spouse or mom, so that she can better take some rest and manage the household things as well as her job properly. So this is, as you said, at some families they are able to divide the chores, whereas some families it is not happening. So in that case, it is naturally the housemaker, the homemaker will be overburdened if it is not shared, because now everybody is at home, so somebody is asking for tea, somebody is asking for some breakfast, somebody is asking something else for medicines, and somebody for this thing and that thing. So then it is to be decided. I would say that have a meeting at your home and decide the chores, the areas, who's going to do what kind of a job, what kind of a chore at home, so that there is no confusion. And of course, there will be some overlapping. There is no fault. And rather, we will have to inculcate this habit to our children that no chore is a lesser job. Because everything is important, and how important it will be to giving respite to your mom to some extent if you help her out in doing some of the activities. So that will be really a very great achievement for them. And when these children, they will go to their hostels after they they grow over, then it will of course be very, very helpful in them to survive in a difficult situation as well. If they learn the some cooking things, that how to cook this thing or that thing, or how to help mom in household chores, and how to go and do some grocery, buy some grocery and help out the mom and dad. So all these things are going to help them out in their future endeavors as well. So this,
definitely,
if we inculcate these habits in our children by doing something by ourselves as well and setting an example, then only they will do it.
Great. Thank you so much, Doctor. We have a reader who has a question here. The reader says, Dr. Dalal, how do we support and deal with family members who are panic stricken and are facing severe anxiety and depression due to the fear of the infection?
Yes. So in that, I would like to say that if you see the data in Indian context, then the mortality is hardly 3%. More than 1 lakh people have been infected by this virus, and till date around 3,000 people, those unfortunate people who are deceased. So we will have to check that this is a disease which is mostly mild to moderate, and hardly I would say that 5 to 10% of people who are requiring hospitalization, and that to a very fraction of them are really getting serious and really requiring oxygen or are on ventilators. So this percentage is hardly 3 to 5%. So rest of them are getting well. So you will have to be hopeful and be positive that even 97% are getting well in India. Only there is 3% of mortality. So therefore, one should be very, very hopeful and follow the guidelines of the government, which the government is releasing from time to time. Follow the norms of it, and follow all the rituals like cough etiquette and your washing and masking yourself and maintaining a social distance and all these kind of things. So that is the norm nowadays. So you follow them as they come, and be hopeful and be positive. And if there are any problems, you think about it that 97% of them are going to get well. So there is nothing to get panic and nothing to get anxious and nothing to get depressed about.
Great. Okay? Thank you so much, Doctor. The next question, Doctor, is about domestic violence. There have been certain reports of domestic violence taking place on a higher note since everyone is locked at home. A lot of stress within family members, leading to a lot of physical and verbal violence. How do people seek help in such situations where they won't be able to step out of their homes?
Yes, of course. They can seek help from the psychologists and psychiatrists. They are there on the platform, and they are providing free of cost help. Telepsychiatry is coming up in a big way, and our society has given a platform in which there are more than 650 psychiatrists who are giving telephonic consultations free of cost. So they can take help, of course, and for that they need not to get out of the house. But the other thing is very, very important is that one factor which is being considered to be responsible for this is the substance use, which addiction, which because of the lockdown, they are taking lot and lot of these addictive substances, and because of which their behavior is getting changed and they are getting angry at the drop of a hat. And they are rather getting abusive or getting assaultive. So I would rather suggest that this is the time to rather understand your spouse in a better way. And this is the time when the God has given you to be together, because before that you probably have not been together for such a long period. So be there at home, be peaceful, think about the difficulties of others, of your spouse or of the other family members, and try to share the responsibilities, as I told you, and try to think about the ordeals of others as well, no? And in this kind of pandemic, try to share, because sharing actually brings down the amount of anxiety and uncertainty. So kindly share your views without getting panic or anxious or depressed. Try to, as I told you before, try to have a good sleep. Do not go for these addicting substances. Try to have a balanced diet, and do your other yoga, pranayama and relaxing exercises so that your anxiety level is less, and try to do things, I would say, jointly. Why not to do some joint activities together? You can have cleaning together, you can be cooking together, watching movies together, and as well as if you are say fond of music, then why not to do some kind of music or dance or whatever. As I told you, there are so many activities, gardening together, and so many things which you can do rather than fighting amongst yourself. This is a, I would say, this is a God-given opportunity for every couple, that you are there and the God has given the time to be together. So why not to utilize it and think that that you will be living together for many, many more years. So why not to improve your relationships? Why not to understand each other well, so that in the later life also, when the lockdowns are over and the situation normalizes, then also you can live happily.
Great. Right? We have another question from a reader. He says, my mother is always worried on call and doesn't get proper sleep because I stay alone in the city and away from home. What should I suggest her?
Yes. So there are certain points which we call it as sleep hygiene. So for like oral hygiene, there is also a sleep hygiene. So in sleep hygiene, what we suggest is that there should be a 6 to 8 hours of time when one should have for sleep, and for this the timing should be fixed, more or less fixed. Supposing like if you want to go to bed at around 10 or 11 p.m. then you try to go to bed during that time daily, right? And what we say is that before going to bed, 1 hour before going to bed, you should stop watching the screens like television, computer or mobile. So 1 hour before, you must stop watching all these things and go to bed. And if you are not getting sleep, you can read maybe some magazine or some newspaper or some other things. But again, it should not be related to COVID. It should be maybe some light story or something like that, which can give you a peace of mind, because reading, it helps getting sleep. That is one. And then even if you are sleeping at late hours, you must get up at the designated time. Supposing you have slept at 11 o'clock, then you must get up and leave the bed by 6 or 7 a.m. in the morning. It doesn't matter at what time you started to have sleep, no? So this is very important. So you get up at 6 or 7 in the a.m. and do your daily chores at that time, and then do not sleep during daytime. That is again very, very important. At the most, you can take a nap of 15 to 20 minutes by watch, not more than that. And okay, if you are feeling sleepy, then you should watch TV by sitting, not by lying down. And then generally we say that at around after 5 p.m., you shouldn't take stimulants like tea, coffee, or what you call cold drink and cola drinks, etc. Because they can hamper in bringing in getting a person going off to sleep. So these, if you follow these things, and plus, as I told you, mild exercises during in the morning and a light exercise in the evening, these all things can bring sleep. One more thing is important, that before going to sleep, you on a say chair and table, you must try to clear your thoughts, that what you have done today and what are the emergent things which you are required to do tomorrow. Do not think, as I told you, long ahead of days or months, but take one day at a time. So before going to sleep, you clear off the clutter of your mind, of your thoughts in your mind, that I will do tomorrow, these things are to be done, so I will do in this way. And that is the end of the story, and you should then go to sleep and read a magazine kind of a thing, and as soon as you are dozing off, you put off your light and go for sleep. So this routine should be followed daily.
So maintaining the routine is the key here. Great.
Maintaining the routine and not to take stimulants or to watch TV and these things, screen things, 1 hour before sleep.
Avoiding screen time as much as possible.
Yeah.
Before we take the last question, I would like to tell all our viewers that we are currently live with psychiatrist Dr. Deepak Dalal. He's here to help you out with some mental issues and other related issues that we have amid the lockdown. The last question for you, Dr. Dalal, is violence related to LGBTQ community, not just in the country, but globally, has seen an increase because this is one of those marginalized community which has already been ignored by the society. And many of them are living with friends or family members who are phobic towards accepting their gender or sexuality. So again, they have similar issues, but it's adding on their problems already. So how does a queer individual deal with such situation?
This is, I would say, really a difficult situation for them because of the problems with the society as such. That if they are locked down in the family, But if the family is tolerant and family has accepted this, that it is not a disease. It is not a disease. It is a God-gifted way of life. So if they have accepted this thing, then it will really be a very peaceful existence. Otherwise, it will be a problem. Because overnight, you cannot change anybody's perception. However, what I would say is that you be patient, don't get angry with them, and you must resolve that it will take time to change anybody's perception. It cannot happen overnight. So better try to adjust with them and try to talk to your community friends, what they are doing, how they are coping up, what kind of things which can be done together, or things like that on social media, or by connecting themselves maybe on Google Duo or kind of such kind of platforms, or even going to the TikTok and all these things. So these things are very, very important, and they should, rather getting angry, they should try to cope up with the situation, try to talk to their parents or family members, and try to try to persuade them and try to tell them that they are also people like anybody else. But certain things which are not in conformity with the current society, but they are also having their own world, their own society, and so many countries have accepted them as such, and they are also doing great jobs. They are also performing greatly in society. So they can, if they can educate their family members by say downloading some of the things through internet or through other media, or their maybe the people who are accepting them in the society, they can let them talk to their family members, and who can broaden their their views regarding LGBT. So all these things are very, very important in this at this juncture. It is definitely a difficult time for them, but losing patience is not going to help. So that Agreed. Is very, very important. And be positive, because lockdown has already started opening up. So it will open up in due course of time, and they will be able to meet their own community people. They can start their own chores and own jobs and all the other things which is held up because of this lockdown, right?
Yeah, agreed, Doctor. Thank you so much. Inferno Atharva, you can drop down your question in the comment section. Doctor will answer your query. The next question, Doctor, is that it's easier comparatively for adults to understand the situation of the lockdown, but kids are unsure of what is happening in their surroundings. It's becoming difficult for parents to make them understand, because since schools have been shut down, their activities of going outside and playing their friends are also completely shut down, and they're trapped within the four walls with their parents. How do parents help kids understand the current scenario so that they equally feel comfortable in the house?
Yes, that is a very good question, and I would say that for comforting the children, the parents, they have to be first comfortable with the current situation. That is very, very important, that they should be comfortable amongst themselves by heart, that as I told you, that although it is very infectious, but hardly 3% is the mortality, 97% of people are getting well. So you will have to tell all these things to your children as well. And the norms, as I told you about all the etiquettes, that whatever the norms which have to be followed, which are to be followed. So they should follow, the parents should follow themselves, and also encourage the children to follow it. That is very, very important, as well as this is the time when the parents can come near to their children, no? Because they have got ample time, their children are also having ample time, so they can really help them in if they are having any difficulties as far as the studies are concerned, or they can play together, have some indoor games, or they can eat together, pray together, stay together. And the one more thing is important, is that they must let their children to talk to their peer groups, so that children can share their views and anxieties with their own colleagues, because that is also very, very important. So let them do some sort of chatting, or maybe some sort of some play some games, maybe let them do some video games, but see to it that it is not they are not overdoing it, so okay. That a tab should be kept on that, okay. So that is very, very important for
maintaining
the,
a tab
for the
on
parents
the screen
to time. Talk to the children to
okay.
tell their children.
Before we ask the next question, I would like to tell our viewers that our next question could be a little triggering. We would request our audience who might be overwhelmed because of the question to sign off. Doctor, the next question is about suicidal thoughts. It's about conversion therapy, because we had a recent... Okay, just pardon us for a moment while we sort our technical glitch.
Yes, tell me. Yes.
Yes. Yes, Doctor. The next question was about certain individuals coping up with the situation with certain defense mechanisms. It includes binge eating. Some of them are dealing with it by self-harming themselves. How can one help themselves in this case?
I mean, really, there is no need to harm self. No, what is there? I mean, the whole world, you'll have to share it. The whole world is undergoing a difficult time, this pandemic. I mean, nobody heard this before in at least one or two generations. Only 1918 one faced with this kind of what you call Spanish flu, but after that only world wars had such kind of things, but nobody heard about any disease like this before. So these are the difficult times for everybody, and one shouldn't get bogged down by these things so that they need to harm themselves. They must try to think positive about it, that what all they can get out of this lockdown. And they can, as I told you, upscale their skills. They can improve their relationships, and they can really go something innovative and something creative, whatever is there, because this is the time. Rather than thinking negative, one should think positive and take one day at a time, and take one little step at a time. That is what I will tell them. That do not get so much bogged down that my work is not, is not happening, and it is 2 months are already gone and this and that. But be hopeful that maybe in near future, as the lockdown is getting over, day by day, the criterion, the stringent criterions are being, liberalized. So I think in due course of time, the things will become more, available and more easier for the people of our country to be normal. So that one should be very hopeful, because hope is the most important thing. Think positive and be hopeful. Do not go for these destructive, devote yourself or give your energy on these destructive activities. Rather, be constructive, be patient, think positive, and generalize these your emotions and views, that whole world is undergoing such kind of a pandemic. So we will fight together, and we will overcome it with a positive note and a positive hope.
Agreed. Thank you so much, Doctor, for helping all our readers today to sort out their mental health issues. We hope we have helped you all. Thank you so much, Dr. Dalal, for joining us.
Thank you. Okay. Bye-bye.
So this is Dr. Dalal, a psychiatrist who helps us solve our mental health issues on our life today. Mumbai Mirror would like to tell you that if there's anything that you would want us to answer in our next COVID conversation, please DM us. Till the time, stay tuned and follow Mumbai Mirror for all the live updates for COVID.